close my eyes, I see the person I was meant to be. I'm going nowhere spinning my wheels in the mud here. You used to say, there ain't no place like home. But I think it's about time to bust this popsicle stand, sis.
mantle to wear.
Thank you.
guess the cat's out of the bag. This weather certainly fits the mood. I think I'm gonna be sick. Probably could have handled that better. I'd give anything to set things straight. You'd know what to do, right? Hey! The heck is that? No way!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
energies collided in a shocking display. A true battle of wills. Then, for the first time, I saw true fear in her eyes. The cavalry had arrived. Professor Pumpkin Jack, Sir Ulysses Talus, and Captain Leopold Goldmane leapt into action. And just in the nick of time, we made sure to bind her up real good. The sacred band had proven the power of their unbreakable bond. Dixie thanked me for seeing her crew through the wicked wood. And we made our merry way to Castle Royalton. Just in time for the festivities. Of course, the Munchkin put on quite a show. Well, Tuck dropped the ball a few times, but the audience was none the wiser. In the end, Dixie closed with a passionate speech, wishing the newly crowned King Lear good health in the years to come. But one thing was still on my mind in a big way. Home. As fate would have it, I awoke in the Winnie on our way to Groovebox. Goes without saying, I set things straight real quick. On the way back home, we discussed our next move. One thing's for sure, nothing's coming between us again. As for LeFaba, well, I kept her true identity to myself. Don't reckon she'll ever fess up to things neither, on account of her pride. Guess a girl's gotta have some secrets. Now, imagine my surprise when Pippa decided to materialize out of the blue. According to her, yours truly's needed back in Glome. ain't no rest for the weary.
LeFaba!